In this video, you will learn how to insert your custom PHP code into your favorite WordPress pages. Here we use a simple PHP code that print a message in marquee HTML tag. This method of inserting code is very flexible. For example, here we insert our code in footer instead of header. Let's check the result. As expected, the message is moved to the bottom of the site. Instead of the article page, let's insert the code in the category page. Let's change WP footer to WP head and change is single to is category. Let's check the result. Now we want our code to be displayed on the tag page in addition to the category page. Here we simply add an or and is tag to our conditions. Let's check the result. Our message is displayed on tag and category pages. Now we insert our code only in the product pages. As you can see, our message is not displayed on other pages of the site. Let's insert PHP code in WordPress frontend. Go to the link in the description, we continue the tutorial according to the article in that link. Copy this snippet code and paste it in your functions.php file. In the WordPress dashboard, go to Appearance Theme File Editor and open functions.php. As you can see, I am using Bloxy child theme. You must create a child theme before making any changes to functions.php, otherwise the applied changes will be lost after each update. Watch video number 1 in channel to learn how to make a child theme. Copy snippet code into functions.php. Now we paste our own PHP code here. Update the file and check the result. Our message will be displayed on all front-end pages of the site. To insert the code in the WordPress admin panel, just delete the exclamation mark from the condition section. Now refresh the admin panel and check the result. As you can see, the code is removed from the front end of the site. Let's insert PHP code in WordPress head. We use WP head hook for this. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Now we paste our own PHP code here. update the file and check the result. As you can see, our message will be displayed in the head section of the site. Let's insert script in WordPress head tag. The process is the same as before, just close the PHP tag and insert your HTML code or script and open the PHP tag again. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Here you can put your Google Analytics code or any HTML code, we write a simple script. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, our script is executing on the site. Let's insert script in WordPress footer. We use WP footer hook for this. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Now we paste our own PHP code here. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, our message will be displayed in the footer of the site. Let's insert script in WordPress footer of the site. The process is the same as before, just close the PHP tag and insert your HTML code or script and open the PHP tag again. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Here you can put your Google Analytics code or any HTML code, we write a simple HTML in here. Update the file and check the result. Let's write a simple script. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, our script is executing on the site. Now let's see how we can insert our code for only specific pages. Here we use WordPress conditional tags. The most used WordPress conditional tag is single. This conditional tag is used to insert code in posts. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Now we paste our own PHP code here. Update the file and check the result. In this demo site, we have two articles. This code is inserted in each article. Now let's make our code be inserted in only one of the articles. In the lower left corner of the screen, you can see that the ID of the post we are looking for is 65. Go back to Theme File Editor. And put the number 65 in here. Now our code is only inserted in Article 1. Now let's see how we can insert PHP code in category pages. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Now we paste our own PHP code here. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, there is nothing on our post pages, and the code is inserted only in the category page. We have two category pages on the site, let's insert our code in only one of them. To do this, go to the posts and categories, and get the slug of the category you want to insert the code in it. Go back to Theme File Editor and put the slug in here. Now our code is only inserted in tutorial category page. Now let's see how we can insert PHP code in tag pages. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Now we paste our own PHP code here. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, the code is inserted in all tag pages of the site. We have two tag pages on the site, let's insert our code in only one of them. To do this, go to the posts and tags, and get the slug of the tag you want to insert the code in it. Go back to Theme File Editor and put the slug in here. Now our code is only inserted in Joomla tag page. Now let's see how we can insert PHP code in Woocommerce product pages. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Now we paste our own PHP code here. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, the code is inserted in all Woocommerce product pages. Now let's see how we can insert PHP code in Woocommerce category pages. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Now we paste our own PHP code here. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, the code is inserted in all WooCommerce category pages. Let's insert our code only in t-shirts category. To do this, copy this category slug which is t-shirts. Go back to theme file editor. Put the slug in here and update file. Now our code is only inserted in t-shirts category. As you can see, our code has been removed from other categories. Now let's see how we can insert PHP code in WooCommerce tag pages. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Now we paste our own PHP code here. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, the code is inserted in all WooCommerce tag pages. Let's insert our code only in gifts category. To do this, copy this tag slug, which is gifts. Go back to theme file editor. Put the slug in here and update file. Now our code is only inserted in gifts tag page. As you can see, our code has been removed from other categories. Now let's see how we can insert PHP code in pages with given terms. In this example, we want to insert our code in all the products that are in the t-shirt category. Copy this snippet code into functions.php. Change his product tag to his product. Now go to the products and category section. Copy product category taxonomy. And paste it here. Now copy the slug of our desired category which is t-shirts. And paste it here. Delete the second one, we don't need it. Now we paste our own PHP code here. Now update file and check the result. Our message is displayed in all products in the t-shirts category. As expected, the message is not displayed in the products that are in the headies category. That's it. If you do have any question or comments about this, please put them below. If you like this video and would like to see more like it, please subscribe. And as always, happy web developing.